Yes. Hello everyone. My name is Công Hà Minh from Viettel Group. Today I and my colleague will bring for you an infrastructure management topic. Yes. Today we will talk about why we need an infrastructure management system and how we use open source solution network to build our own infrastructure management system. Yes, for the first, I will introduce you a little about my company, Viettel. We are a big telco and IT cloud and a telco provider in Vietnam and other 10 countries in the world. So we have many customers. So to provide telco and IT service to many customers in the world, about 100 of billion customers, we need a very big infrastructure to deploy our IT and telco service. That we have many things to manage, such as from physical component as server, switch router, to a network component such as network RS, MAC RS, or some network connection. We also have many logical cluster components, such as cloud storage, load balancer pairing. This reality, we have to manage many things in our infrastructure. So we have many demands on many things. First, we need to have an information management system to audit, to check how many resources in the infrastructure we are using and how many left. For example, we have many racks, but some racks are used, and we need to checking how many space available for us and how many left. For example, another example is IP management. We have many traffic, but some traffic has used, but some not used. Then we want to check how many IP available in each prefix, so we can use this available IP to create new VM, to deploy my new IT service. So the second demand that we need to upgrading our infrastructure in a single place. So then other system in our ecosystem can use this infrastructure management system to add inputs or data for monitoring, for auditing, for alerting. So for example, that's when a VM in our infrastructure has problem, then the alert system, the monitoring system need to assess this single infrastructure management system to collect what the owner, the manager of this VM is, and the location of this VM. So can alert the VM manager so he can see that the VM is down, and he's responsible to access to this VM and fix and bring up it again. So the other demand is check the difference between our desired state with the current state. For example, can we have some VM has duplicate IP in the environment due to human error, misconfig. So that we need a infrastructure management system to detect it and then alert to VM manager, to object manager to fix it. to correct that no VM in our infrastructure has duplicate IP, ensure that the system work correctly. So for the three requirements, as I talk to you, we had evaluate many solutions. The first solution is we can buy a commercial solution from a provider such as the single solution is we buy we can build our solution from scratch, but it's very cost many human and money to make it. Then the first solution for us is based on open source solution, and then add our need to extend the solution to meet our requirement. So after evaluating the solution, we decide to base our IT infrastructure in management system on networks. It's a very popular solution infrastructure management system currently. So why we chose it? Yes, first network currently provide for Alchemy almost the feature we need to manage our infrastructure system. So the second reason is network has an open source. It's an open source solution with an open design. So our company easily extend it to add our need feature. It's beyond the Django, and has an HTTP REST API, so we can integrate our system or other system, so that many monitoring system, audit system, and alert system to the network to provide input for other system. So it has many features our company need, such as it can manage device, manage IP address, manage rack reservation, so we can use it for monitoring, for auditing, for capital liability planning, with it for device, for physical component, for IP address. But with a big company like us, we need a more HR feature for our daily activity monitoring on operating our infrastructure. So what is the first network only provides the solution. Sorry, network only provides solution for manage a basic device component, a single device, or a rack chassis device, but currently it do not manage the logical component, so that's cloud, storage system, or a pairing load balancer. So but our company need to manage this. The second, sometimes we need some more data from real world. We need to collect to provide input for the management and operating activities. Network do not have an automatic recovery service for them. For the third requirement is sometimes our company need to validate if the real state and the desired state in our infrastructure are different. So as I talked earlier, we can identify it and let the owner manager of the object can fix it to bring it in our design architect. So to solve this zone three problem, that's our solution is The first, we extend network to add more capability to can manage the logical cluster object. So that we add more the Django class and API to manage these objects in the infrastructure. So the second, we add some feature to manage the extra object to manage the data from automation discovery system to put it in the web service. To we can collect it and when network operator need it, it can access to the web service to see it in and use it to fix the problem when happen. So the third, we build a discovery service. The service will collect data from real object, from object in infrastructure, and collect it and put it in the web service. And the second feature of the discovery service is compare the design state the network manager put in a web service and compare with the real state in the environment. And it when it detects the difference, it's then alert to the object manager to show the object manager and the network operator can detect it, and the fix is to bring back the real state to the desired state. So what is the feature we add to network to complete the feature we need to in our company? That's the first. You can see that we had some new capability to manage the load balancer pairing cluster. It can have two or three load balancer device in a pairing, and we add a new object called as load balancer to manage them. And we can manage some extra information from it, such as VIP endpoint, or we can manage more in its switch route. That many operator of a company need them when troubleshooting an issue, infrastructure problem. So the second feature we add is detect the mistake between the real state and the desired state. As you can see, that we have two VM with a duplicate IP. When the discovery service detects that, it can trigger an alert to manager and operator in an email. So when they have email, then they can access to the device and fix it. So this is the feature we add to network to manage our infrastructure management system. So this is my presentation. Thank you. So do you have any question? Or anyone use network to manage the infrastructure? Yes. Yes.
So we are planning to add some plugins, and for now we just need some more information. So I've seen you have added some objects.
Yes.
At the web service. So is there a difference? To my understanding, you can either have a web service with a plugin that communicates with networks, or you can add object as a JSON in the database. So the only difference I see that is that you have the information in the NetBox dashboard when you add objects, but you don't have any information if you use a plugin. Is there any other difference?
Yes, my current implementation on our company is using a fork from network core, and when an upstream has update, we must east. Yes, so it's give me more flexible to customize network to adapt all requirement. But because network plugin sometimes it cannot have enough flexible for us. Yes, but we have more time to merge code from upstream. So we must to design our bytecode to not conflict with network core. Yes. Another question. Do you have any question for me? Thank you very much.